Hello and welcome to the session. In this session we discuss the following question, which says solve the differential equation x plus 5y minus 3 the whole dx is equal to 3x plus 4y minus 2 whole dy. If we are given the equation of the kind dy by dx equal to ax plus by plus c upon capital AX plus capital BY plus capital C, then such equations are reduced to homogeneous form by taking the small x as capital X plus H and small y as capital Y plus K, where these H and K are constants which are so chosen to make the given equation homogeneous. And we know that the differential equation of the form dy by dx equal to f of xy upon phi of xy, where this f of xy and phi of xy are the homogeneous functions of x and y and are of same degree. So this is the key idea that we use for this question. Let's proceed with the solution now. The given differential equation is x plus 5y minus 3 the whole dx is equal to 3x plus 4y minus 2 the whole dy. Now this equation can be written as dy by dx is equal to x plus 5y minus 3 the whole upon 3x plus 4y minus 2. So this equation is of the form dy by dx is equal to ax plus by plus c upon capital AX plus capital BY plus capital C. And now we will reduce this given equation to homogeneous form by taking small x equal to capital X plus H and small y equal to capital Y plus K. So now putting small x equal to capital X plus H and small y equal to capital Y plus K. So we now have d capital Y upon d capital X is equal to capital X plus H, that is in place of X we put capital X plus H, plus 5 into capital Y plus K the whole minus 3 this whole upon 3 into capital X plus H plus 4 into capital Y plus k the whole minus 2. This gives us d capital Y upon d capital X is equal to capital X plus H plus 5 capital Y plus 5k minus 3 this whole upon 3 capital X plus 3h plus 4 capital Y plus 4k minus 2. Or we can write this as d capital Y upon d capital X is equal to capital X plus 5 capital Y plus H plus 5K minus 3 this whole upon 3 capital X plus 4 capital Y plus 3H plus 4K minus 2. Now, we need to find H and K, and for this, we take H plus 5K minus 3 is equal to 0, that is we take this equal to 0, and 3H plus 4K minus 2 is equal to 0, and this expression is equal to 0. Now we will solve these two equations to get the values of H and K. So from here we have H upon 5 into minus 2 is minus 10 minus of 4 into minus 3, that is minus of minus 12, which becomes plus 12, is equal to minus k upon minus 2 into 1, that is minus 2, minus of 3 into minus 3, that is minus of minus 9, and that becomes plus 9, is equal to 1 upon 4 into 1 is 4, minus 3 into 5 is 15. So h upon 2 is equal to minus k upon 7 is equal to 1 upon minus 11. And from here we can say that h is equal to minus 2 upon 11 and k is equal to 7 upon 11. Consider this equation to be equation number 1. Now, from equation 1, we have d capital Y upon d capital X is equal to capital X plus 5 capital Y plus 0. So in the numerator we have capital X plus 5 capital Y. Now we have taken this term to be 0. Now in the same way, in the denominator we have 3 capital X plus 4 capital Y plus 0, as this term is also taken as 0. So here we have 3 capital X plus 4 capital Y. Now this equation is a homogeneous equation. So we have reduced the given equation to homogeneous form. Now to solve this, we take capital Y equal to V into capital X. Now differentiating both sides with respect to capital X, we have d capital Y by d capital X is equal to V plus capital X into dv by d capital X. Now let this be equation number 2. Now substituting these values of capital Y and d capital Y by d capital X in equation 2, we get V plus capital X into dV by d capital X is equal to capital X plus 5 into, now in place of Y we put V capital X upon 3 capital X plus 4 into capital Y, that is V capital X. So we now have V plus capital X into dV by d capital X is equal to capital X plus 5V capital X upon 3 capital X plus 4V capital X. Now further we have V plus capital X into dV by d capital X is equal to, taking capital X common in the numerator, capital X into 1 plus 5V the whole, and this whole upon taking capital X common from the denominator, we have capital X into 3 plus 4V the whole. Now this XX cancels, and now further we have capital X into dV by d capital X is equal to 1 plus 5V upon 3 plus 4V minus V, which gives us capital X into dV by d capital X is equal to 1 plus 5V minus 3V minus 4V square, this whole upon 3 plus 4V. Then capital X into dV by d capital X is equal to minus of 4V square minus 2V minus 1 the whole and this whole upon 3 plus 4b. Now, separating the variables, we have 3 plus 4b upon 4v square minus 2v minus 1 the whole dv is equal to minus d capital X upon capital X. Next, integrating both sides, we have integral of 3 plus 4v upon 4v square minus 2v minus 1 the whole dv is equal to minus integral d capital X upon capital X. Now multiplying both sides by 2, we get integral of 6 plus 8v upon 4v square minus 2v minus 1 the whole dv is equal to minus 2 integral d capital X upon capital X. Now further we have integral 6 plus 8v can be written as 8v minus 2 plus 8 the whole dv upon 4v square minus 2v minus 1 is equal to minus 2 integral d capital X upon capital X. And further we can write this as integral 8v minus 2 upon 4v square minus 2v minus 1 the whole dv plus 8 integral dv upon 4v square minus 2v minus 1 is equal to minus 2 integral d capital X upon capital X. Now for solving this integral, we take let 4v square minus 2v minus 1 be equal to t. Now differentiating both sides with respect to t, we have 8v minus 2 the whole dv is equal to dt. So we further have integral dt by t, that is in place of 8v minus 2 dv we write dt. So dt by t plus 8 upon 4 integral dv upon, now we have taken 4 common from the denominator, so in the denominator we now have v square minus 1 upon 2 v minus 1 upon 4, this is equal to minus 2 integral d capital X upon capital X. So this gives us log of modulus t plus 2 into integral dv upon, now this denominator, that is v square minus 1 upon 2 v minus 1 upon 4 can be written as v square minus 1 upon 2 v plus 1 upon 16 minus 1 upon 16, that is we have added and subtracting 1 upon 16 minus 1 upon 4. So this is further equal to v square minus 1 upon 2v plus 1 upon 16 minus 5 upon 16. And so we can write this as v minus 1 upon 4 the whole square minus 5 upon 16. So here we write in the denominator v minus 1 upon 4 whole square minus 5 upon 16, and so this is equal to minus 2 log of modulus capital X plus the constant of integration C. Now in place of t here we put this value. So we have log modulus of 4v square minus 2v minus 1 plus 2. Now integral of dv upon v minus 1 upon 4 whole square minus 5 upon 16 would be equal to integral of dv upon v minus 1 upon 4 whole square minus root 5 upon 4 whole square. Now the value of this integral is equal to 1 upon 2 into a, which is root 5 upon 4 into log modulus of v minus 1 upon 4 minus root 5 upon 4, this whole upon v minus 1 upon 4 plus root 5 upon 4. Here we have used the formula of integration. Integral dx upon x square minus a square is equal to 1 upon 2a log of modulus x minus a upon x plus a. So thus here we have 2 into 1 upon 2 root 5 upon 4, so we write 4 here, into log modulus v minus 1 upon 4 minus root 5 upon 4, this whole upon v minus 1 upon 4 plus root 5 upon 4, and this is equal to minus 2 log modulus capital X plus the constant of integration C. So this gives us log modulus 4v square minus 2v minus 1. Now this 2 and 2 cancels, and so we have plus 4 upon root 5 into log modulus 4v minus root 5 minus 1 upon 4v plus root 5 minus 1, and this is equal to minus 2 log of modulus x plus the constant of integration C. We have taken capital Y is equal to V into capital X. This means that V is equal to capital Y by capital X. So now, putting V equal to capital Y by capital X, we get log modulus 4 into capital Y square upon capital X square minus 2 into capital Y upon capital X minus 1 plus 4 upon root 5 into log modulus 4 into capital Y upon capital X minus root 5 minus 1, this whole upon 4 into capital Y upon capital X plus root 5 minus 1 is equal to minus 2 log modulus capital X plus the constant of integration C. So this gives us log modulus 4 capital Y square minus 2 into capital X into capital Y minus capital X square, this whole upon capital X square plus 4 upon root 5 into log modulus 4 into capital Y minus root 5 into capital X minus capital X, this whole upon 4 into capital Y plus root 5 into capital X minus 1. and this is equal to minus 2 log modulus capital X plus the constant of integration C. This further gives us log modulus 4 capital Y square minus 2 capital X capital Y minus capital X square, this whole upon capital X square plus 4 upon root 5 log modulus 4 into capital Y minus 1 plus root 5 into capital X upon 4 into capital Y minus 1 minus root 5 the whole into capital X is equal to minus 2 log modulus capital X plus the constant of integration C. Now earlier we had got the value of H as minus 2 by 11 and value of K as 7 upon 11. So this means the small x, or you can say capital X, is written as small x minus the value of H. So minus minus becomes plus 2 upon 11. In the same way, from here we have capital Y is equal to Y minus the value of capital K. And so, as K is 7 upon 11, so here we have Y minus 7 upon 11. This is the required solution when we have capital X equal to small x plus 2 upon 11 and capital Y is equal to small y minus 7 upon 11. So this is our final answer. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.